Hi, and welcome to the Flux channel. Today we're going to be looking at the Elixir limiter. If this kind of content interests you, feel free to subscribe to our channel. Limiting is considered to be dynamic treatment, and Elixir is a particular type of limiter, known as a true peak limiter. That signifies that it has an infinite compression ratio and its attack time is to the nearest sample. This guarantees that the level will never pass the determined threshold, and so we can raise the average level without ever saturating the output stage. So with this in mind, Elixir is an ideal tool for the final stage of mastering in music or video productions that are destined for YouTube or the internet in general. So here's our session in Reaper with the song that we're mastering. Before beginning this step, I made sure to calibrate my 0 dB VU in Reaper to minus 10 dB FS, as that's the level I'll be aiming for when using the limiter. So here's the Elixir plugin. Here we have its principal functions with the input gain, the output gain, and the threshold. A classic use for a limiter is to use the input gain to give it the desired level. It's quite a straightforward way of working with a limiter. However, in the case of Elixir, we're dramatically limiting its potential. Elixir's algorithm can use several stages in order to treat the sound. The number of stages is determined by the stages fader, which functions in pair with the threshold. Here's a simple example. If I fix the number of stages to 3 and the threshold to minus 3 decibels, the Elixir will first analyse the initial signal and limit it to minus 1 dB, then analyse it a second time, limiting at minus 2 dB, before a third and final time, limiting at minus 3 dB. I'll now create the same signal boost, but this time using the input gain, the threshold, and a higher number of stages. My first task is to raise the input gain so as to just trigger the limiter. Now, while increasing the number of stages and activating the makeup gain, I'm going to decrease the threshold. So let's compare this limiter setting with the first one we did. So here's our first limiter setting. And here's our second limiter setting. I find the result with this setting more transparent and more natural, but I find that we lose a certain aggressivity and a certain saturation that was interesting with the first setting. We can try and find this aggressivity by playing with the speed setting. By default, this setting is set to 50%. When turning down this setting, we decrease the limiter's saturation and favour its compression capabilities. On the contrary, if we turn it up, we'll decrease its compression and increase the saturation aspect of the limiter. So if it's aggressivity we're looking for, we'll want to saturate. We will now look at the last setting called the channel link, meaning that if the limiter is triggered by an event on the left channel, only the left channel will be limited. The treatment of the limiter is therefore optimized, but we risk affecting the stability of the stereo image. Inversely, by setting the channel link to 100%, the two channels will now be treated identically. This enables us to preserve our stereo image. However, the treatment of the limiter will not be optimal. The dynamic option gives us the best of both worlds. The transients are treated in a discriminate fashion, while the rest of the signal is treated as a whole. So now let's listen with and without the channel link in dynamic mode. Personally, I'd use the channel link at 100% with the dynamic mode activated because I find the result to be more natural and the stereo image more stable. Now, let's compare our original mix with our two limiter settings. To do this, I'm going to balance the output gain, and begin with the limiter deactivated. With our first limiter setting, and with our second limiter setting, I find the first setting to be more saturated and tense, but perhaps a little caricatural. I find the second setting a lot more transparent and more respectful of the mix's integrity. With that in mind, I know that I can always further limit it if ever I need to achieve an even higher sound level. Thanks for watching. Feel free to subscribe if you like this content and activate the notifications if you want to keep up to date with all new things to come. As for us, we'll see you in the next video on the Flux channel.